Now let's go to naming alcohols. All right, we have, assuming we have a compound of this type, HOCCH32C, then we have CH3, then we have CH3CH2OH. OH. Now the structural formula of this compound is HO linked to a carbon with two methyl groups. That carbon is linked to another carbon with a methyl group. The carbon is linked to another carbon with a methyl group. Okay, meaning between these two carbon atoms there is a double bond. Linked to another carbon with a methylene group and hydroxy group of alcohol. Okay, we have two functional groups here. I mean, yes, we may say that. The carbon-carbon double bond of alkene and the hydroxy functional group of alkanol. But this takes precedence, you don't forget. But we have to identify the longest carbon chain length. Most of you used to make this silly mistake by counting the carbon from here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Or from here. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's wrong. It's not correct. Because if you start from here, 1, 2, 3, 4, there is another carbon here, and there is another carbon here. It's either you come this way or go that direction. So if we start from here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, there are 5 carbon atoms on the straight chain and not 4. Now, which direction are we to start from? If we start from here, the hydroxy group will be on carbon 1 here, then 2, 3, 4, on carbon 4 here. If we start from here, it will be on carbon 1, 2, carbon 2, 3, 4, 5, 2 and 5, 2 and 5, 1 and 4. 1 and 4 are less than 2 and 5, so we must start our numbering from this carbon atom. So meaning the substituents are methyl group on carbon 4, another one on carbon 2, another one on carbon 3. So we have 2, 3, 4, trimethyl, okay, pent on carbon 3, I mean carbon 2, there is a double bond, 2, 8, then on carbon 1 and 4, there are two hydroxy groups, 2, 8, you have to put E. Because we want to write the letter B after that. 1,4-diol. 1,4-diol. That's the name of the compound. Then I want you to look at something of this nature as well. We have something like this. Okay? So here, assuming there is an hydroxy group here, there is a methyl group here. Hydroxy group here, there is a fluoro here, methyl there, there is a methyl here, there is a bromo here. There is a bromo here, then there is a methyl group here. Let us know we have compound of this type. Of course, you have to negate. Look at the position of the functional group. Okay? In this time around, I want to put a triple bond here. Okay, let me put a double bond here. And again, let me put a double bond here. Okay? 1, 2, 3. Triple bond. Now, the hydroxy group takes precedence, so this must be our carbon 1, carbon 2, carbon 3, carbon 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Alright? Now, we have to name bromo before chloro. So, we have 6, 6-dibromo. Then, the chloro are on carbon 1. I think that's all. 1, chloro. Then, the ethyl group on carbon 4. 4 ethyl. We have a methyl group on carbon 1, another one on carbon 2. Those are the methyl group you have. So 1, 2. Oh, excuse me. This is a methyl group. So that means this carbon atom too is part of the straight chain. We have to remember. Sorry about that. It's part of the straight chain. So that means our numbering must start from this carbon. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That's a no. Because of the double bond, no, and so on and so forth. So this name is incorrect. So again, the chloro is now on carbon 2, and we have the bromo on carbon 7. 7, dibromo. Then we have fluoro on carbon 2, 2 chloro. Then ethyl group on carbon 5, 5 ethyl. any methyl group again, because we remove that. Yes, on carbon 3. 3 methyl non. On carbon 8, there is a triple bond. 8-ine. Okay? On carbon 4, there is a double bond. 4-ine. On carbon 2 and carbon 3, there are hydroxyl group. 2,3-diol. This is the name of the compound and not the other way around. Now, in case we have other type of functional group, as in this case, I want us to look at C, okay, OHC, C, CH32, C, CH2, CH3, okay? We have a compound of this kind. Then we have C, Cl2, CHO. Anytime you see a compound with CHO, it indicates alkali functional group. So the structure of the compound is C double bond OH. This linked to another carbon containing two methyl groups. That carbon is linked to another carbon containing an ethyl group. Okay, well, this is supposed to be two ethyl groups, CH2, CH3, linked to another carbon containing two chloro groups, linked to another carbonyl group of alkana. So the compound is actually an alkana. Now, when you are determining the longest carbon chain length, it must the two functional groups of the same family must be part of the straight chain. So if we start from here, this will be on carbon 1, and this will be on 2, 3, 4, 5, carbon 5. Same way, if you start from here, you still have 1 and 5. But you have to consider the position of the substrate. If you start from here, this will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 2 plus 2, 4, 3 plus 3, 6 plus 4, 10. 4 plus 4, 8 plus 10, that will give you 18. Starting from here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We have 2 plus 2, 4, 3 plus 3, we still have 18. So you now take care, the direction that will give you the actual name of the compound will now be the direction that has the least position of the first substituent to be named. And the first substituent to be named here is chloro, meaning we have to start from the right hand side. So that's the correct numbering system. And that will give us 2,2-dichloro. Yes, 3,3. Diethyl, yes, we have 4,4 dimethyl, then we have penta 1,5-dihal, or you can write it as pentane 1,5-dihal or 1,5-pentane-dihal. That is as well correct. Now consider this. Taking another functional group, we have O, OH. Then we have NH2. I want us to look at this clearly, thinking carefully. Then here you have N, something like this. Here you have a chloro. Then here you have an hydroxyl group. Okay, there is a methyl group here. Don't forget there is a methyl group here. Assuming we have this kind of compound, okay, and we have something like this as well, O, then OH. This is a carboxylic acid. Don't forget that there are other functional groups in this compound, like amino functional group of amine, hydroxyl functional group of alcohol. But this takes precedence. From either side, the carboxyl groups are on both sides at the last carbon atom from either side. So you can start from here or start from here. The position of the carboxyl groups is the same. But you have to consider the position of the substituent. Starting from here, this is carbon 1. The amino here will be on carbon 2. This will be on carbon 3, carbon 4. So 2 plus 4 plus 4 will give us 10. 5 will give us 15. 6 will give us 12 plus 15, 27. That's 27. If you start from here, 1, 2, 2, 4, plus 3, 7, plus 4, 11, plus 4, 15, this is 5, 6, plus 15, 21. So meaning we have to start from this direction. It will give us the least position of the subsystem. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Because there are 7 carbon atoms, the compound is heptanedioic acid. The 2 carboxyl group, heptanedioic acid. So we have an amino group, 2 of such, of different kinds. This is a primary amino, this is a tertiary amino. Then we have a chloro, we have an 2 hydroxyl group. Amino first, so we have 6 amino. Then we have 4 N dimethyl amino, or precisely you can start with 4 instead of 6, no problem. Then we have chloro after amino, 4 chloro. Okay, after that, what next? We have methyl groups. No, we have hydroxy group. Hydroxy before methyl, H before M. So that gives us 2 dihydroxy. Okay, then we have what again? Methyl on carbon 3 and carbon 6. 3, 6 dimethyl heptane 1, 7. Okay, dioic acid. Heptane 1, 7 dioic acid. So this is the name. How to name carboxylic acid. But in case you have an ester, which is an alkanoid, the simplest member of that is this, OOCH3, something like this. You name the alkyl group on the side chain before you name the parent. You know, this is the functional group. There are 2 carbon atoms here. So you name this methyl as methyl ethanoid. But when you have alkanoids with large carbon atoms, like for instance, you have something like this, O, C, CH3, Br, C, 1, 2, 3, C, then you have C, O, O, C, CH3, CH3, CH2, CH3. Assuming you have something like this. Now the alkyl group on the side chain must be named first. And this is the alkyl group. Meanwhile, this alkyl group, this is the first carbon that is linked to the functional group. So you name this as carbon 1 prime. This is carbon 2 prime, carbon 3 prime. So that means on carbon 1 there are 2 methyl groups. Now the straight chain compound, the straight chain of the compound contains 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 carbon atoms. That is hexanoid. Because there is a triple bond, hexane, not it. Now this carbon oxygen double bond will be named as a suffix, I mean as a prefix, which is oxo. This is a carbonyl group of alkanoid, but because alkanoid takes precedence, we have carbon 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now the side chain, we have 1' dimethyl. Okay, propyl, just the way we name this, dimethyl propyl. Then we now come to the straight chain, the root name of the compound. On carbon 4, there is a bromo. There is no hyphen in between this and this, just like there is no hyphen between this methyl and ethanoid. So you have 4 bromo. What again? We have a methyl group still on carbon 4, 4 methyl. Okay, X on carbon 2, there is a triple bond, 2 ion. Ion what? Okay, so on carbon 5, there is an oxo. Okay, we need to name oxo. That is 5 oxo. We now have 2 ion. Know it. 2 ion. Know it. That's how to name esters. The same way you name alkanamide as well as other class of compounds with side chain. And look at this. You have something of this nature. O. And here we have chloro. Here we have bromo. Then here you have a methyl. Here you have a methyl. When you have this kind of compound, this is not a carbon, this end, because it is bromo that ended it. Likewise here, but these are the functional group. So this must be carbon 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carbon. And because we have two carbonyl group of ketone, that must be diol. So on carbon 1, there is, okay, this functional group is different from this. Very good. This one is an alkanoyl chloride. This is not a ketone. Why this one is, this is a carbonyl group of alkanoyl chloride. Why this is a carbonyl group of ketone? So you name this carbonyl group as oxo, and the name of the compound must end with oil chloride. So on carbon 2, there is, carbon 3, there is an oxo, carbon 5, there is a bromo, on carbon 4, there is a methyl. So we have 5 bromo, what again, methyl oxo, 2 methyl, 3 oxo, and we have pentanoyl chloride. That's the name of the compound. Okay? So you are expected to be able to name different kinds of straight chain alkene organic compounds. Like for instance, you have something like this, OH, CH3, C, you have this, you have this, Cl, Cl, you have this, O, N, you have CH3, you have CH2, CH2, CH3. This is an amide. So because this compound is an amide, because of the carbonyl group linking to a nitrogen atom, and this amide is a tertiary, this nitrogen is a tertiary hydrogen, nitrogen, because there are three carbons surrounding it. So this is the functional group, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's a pentanamide. But you have to name the side chain. We have N-methyl, N-propyl. N-methyl, N-propyl. Yes, that is on carbon 2. We have 2-2 dichloro. Okay? Then we have 4-hydroxy. On carbon 4, we also have the methyl group. 4-methyl. Okay? On carbon 3, we have an oxo. 3-oxo. Then pentanamide. Pentanamide. This is how to name amide. There are other classes of organic compounds whose names are not considered. But let's take one more example. Okay, let's look at this compound. 3, 4, 5, 6, something of this nature. Alright? Assuming we have a double bond here, a chloro here, a chloro here, then you have an amino here, you have another, let's say, a triple bond here, then you have a methyl group on this carbon. Now, the functional group here, the main functional group is the cyano group of alkylonitrile on carbon 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That is octanonitrile, octanonitrile. So we have amino group on carbon 4, which is to be named first, 4 amino. On carbon 2, we have 2. On carbon 3, we have 3. Dichloro. Then we have on carbon 7 a methyl group, 7-methyl octano, there is a triple bond on carbon 5, there is a double bond on carbon 2. So triple bond is named first, 5-2-ino-nitrile. So if you remove the numbers 2 and 5, that will give you octaninonitrile, which is the name of the compound. Another example is this. Okay, we have something like this. O, assuming there is bromine here. Then you have another carbonyl group here. There is a methyl group here. There is a methyl group here. There is a methyl group here. Okay? So let's assume here we have an iodo and here we have a bromo. Now this compound has two carbonyl groups. One on this carbon, this is a carbonyl group of ketone. Another one on this carbon, this is a carbonyl group of alkanoid halide. So this must be the functional group because it takes precedence. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We still have 8 carbon atoms. So numbering, naming the substituent, bromo is to be named first on carbon 6. That is 6 bromo. Okay? Then ethyl on carbon 4 and 6. 4, 6, diethyl. What again? We have a methyl group. We have methyl groups on carbon 2. Then we have iodo. I think iodo has to be named first. I before N. 4, iodo. Then we have 2, 2, dimethyl. Okay? 2, 2 dimethyl. That will give us 5-oxo-octanonitrile. Octanoil bromide. Because that's a bromine. Alright. Now, in case you have a compound of this kind, okay, you have a compound of this kind, OH here, then you have carbonyl group here, likewise here, assuming there is an amino group, then here, there is a carbonyl group again, likewise here, you have the double bond. There is nothing to worry about. This compound is actually an amide. Because there are four functional groups. Amide, carbonyl group of ketone, hydroxy, alkene. So this must be your carbon 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now, to name the substituent, hydroxy followed by oxo, we have three hydroxo, 2 oxo, okay? Pent, 3-enamide. So I'm sure with this you should be able to name any straight chain or branching organic compound, specifically any aliphatic organic compound. In our subsequent series, we are going to discuss how to name cyclic organic compounds as well as bicyclic organic compounds before we move on to isomerism in our subsequent edition. Thank you so much for listening. I believe you have learned one or two things today. See you again next time. Thank you and stay blessed.